This episode of Byte-Sized Science is kind of special to me. Normally, experts and scientists just go out in the field and they film themselves using a smartphone or some sort of action camera. But in this situation, I actually got to leave the hustle and bustle of the city and go in the field with one of our experts, Roger Paulen. And the great thing about Roger is he's not only a geologist, he's also a philosopher.
So what did you find there?
Myself, my soul. So we are here in northern Labrador on the coastline in a region that has really never been mapped in any great detail. And what we're mapping is the surficial geology, and that is the geology impacted from the last ice sheets, the last glaciation that impacted all of North America.
Surficial geology maps represent the land's surface. They reflect the evolution of a landscape through time. These maps are important, especially in a glaciated landscape like Canada. They are used for multiple purposes, such as land use planning, mineral exploration, etc. In North America, the continental ice sheets, the most recent of which is the Laurentide ice sheet, eroded and shaped the landscape that we see now. In the field, we map the former paths that these ice sheets once flowed.
When ice moves across a landscape, it flows. And as it flows, it tears off pieces of rock, crushes them, and incorporates them into its base. When the ice flows over a rocky outcrop here, the pieces of rock will rub against the surface, creating what we call glacial erosion marks. This is very important for reconstructing the glacial history of a region, as it gives us information about the direction of glacial transport, which is why we're going to measure them on a regional scale for our mapping.
In the process of making a new surficial geology map, we collect observations and samples from various materials at the surface. These data points and samples allow us to piece together a puzzle which brings our map to life. Every map visually can tell a story, and in this case we are unraveling the glacial history of coastal Labrador. Till is a sediment formed directly by glaciers as a product of erosion, transport, and deposition. It is deposited over time as the glaciers flow from their thickest point, or ice centers, to their edges. It is an important sample medium as it allows us to characterize the sediments we map at the surface and document where they originated.
We found a site with some glacial sediments, so we're going to collect some samples to get a regional geochemistry and heavy mineral background data on this. And you can see the glacial sediments right at the surface here, so that's what we're looking for.
These till samples are a major piece of building a surficial map, but we also collect other types of samples to help us complete the puzzle.
We're sampling the tops of these boulders here to get a better idea of when those ice sheets melted from the coastline of Labrador. We chose this hilltop next to the ocean's edge, and specifically we chose a boulder with a relatively flat surface that we just collected a sample from, that we will use to constrain the age of when this boulder was first exposed to the atmosphere, in meaning the glaciers had receded at this point in eastern Canada. We can measure how long a boulder's been exposed to the atmosphere by measuring the isotopes that have altered in the surface minerals of this rock.
These isotopes accumulate over time within the quartz crystals of this boulder. Those isotopes are created when cosmic radiation interacts with the Earth's atmosphere and creates new particles that react with the rock.
This is a raised feature we landed at relative to all the other features around here, so chances are this is an old delta.
A former delta in a glacial landscape marks where glacial meltwaters flowed into a glacial lake. We can sample these features to map where the land was once exposed, immediately after the glaciers had melted.
We can actually collect a sample from the really fine sandy material to put an age date on that delta. So we shove in a black PVC pipe into the face. What we want to do with these grains of sand is actually measure when they were last exposed to sunlight. And then we could actually measure their luminescence that's been buried ever since then.
Similarly, when a glacial lake drains, these fine-grained sands can be picked up and transported by very strong winds coming off the ice sheet, which we call katabatic winds. These katabatic winds transport and deposit these fine-grained sands as sand dunes. So we end up with these beautiful fine-grained sand dunes in the middle of the boreal forest here in northern Canada.
We are on a very old sand dune, and we're going to collect another OSL date. See how long ago this sand dune formed.
So what you're seeing here is a process of weathering. So using my shadow here, you see a bit of the burnt in the old soil profile with some younger sand on top. This orange mottled layer is what we call the B horizon, and it's been oxidized over a few thousand years. So we're actually trying to get right to the bottom there for this type of sand, which is generally unoxidized.
Along the coastline of Labrador, there are raised beaches. This site is an excellent example of one. So these beaches were not formed from higher sea levels. They actually are the result of the land being pushed down into the Earth's mantle because the weight of these continental ice sheets was so intense on the landscape. When the ice glaciers melted, they melted faster than that land could rebound. And the ocean then came in to the newly exposed landscape, which slowly rose over time, creating layers of or elevations of different beaches all along the coastline.
Sample along with the other bag you see at his feet gets sent to a lab. It's one of only, I think, two or three labs in Canada that will date when the sand grains in this sediment were last exposed to cosmic radiation, sunlight.
All these data go into building a surficial map, which allows us a better understanding of the impact that continental glaciers had on the landscape. These maps are important for future research, mineral exploration, and can also be used by communities to support existing and future infrastructure. What these maps portray is the surficial geology of the land surface that we all live on.
Thank you for watching this video. It was a great experience hanging out in the field with Roger, Jessey, and Pierre-Marc. I find it incredible that we can actually see in the landscape evidence of things that happened over 10,000 years ago. If you're like me and you need more Roger in your life, check out this video on screen right now. It's all about how our research scientists are exploring for minerals by following the path of glaciers. Make sure to do all the YouTube things, like and subscribe, and keep an eye out for our next video.